present the business impact of new European Union General Data Protection Regulation on organization. I was talking with Sebastian, the last presentation, and he presented several techniques that are complementary with this presentation. My background, I am more experienced with in the implementation of management system, integrated management system, 20001, 27001, and 20000 is IT service management, is one of the management systems that are mostly used in Portugal, integrated with information security and quality management in IT organizations. I have also experience in the certification audit of management systems, working with the national certification body for 20 years, mainly in the public and organization, IT organizations. Actually, I'm working with the accreditation body, is the Accreditation Institute of Portugal, and where I'm responsible for the certification scheme in Portugal and auditing teams and certification organizations. I'm also PCB partner and the PCB certified trainer. I have several certifications, mainly in information security, IT service management, and ITIL and the Scrum Agile also. I organized this presentation talking about what is the GDPR, what is the implication of the security in organizations, security and risk management in the area of personal data. I will cover one technique, is data protection impact assessment, is when the main things in the implementation of GDPR in organizations, like in information security, is a risk-based approach. In this implementation of GDPR, it's also a risk-based approach. They have several differences. I will cover these differences in my presentations and present some conclusions. The GDPR also, as mentioned in the previous presentation and yesterday, it's a new regulation for the European states. It will be effective in the 25 May next year. This will bring very benefits to the states members, because we will cover with one law 27 countries, and the estimate is a reduction of 2.3 billion per year only when legislation for all European Union. This regulation is also what to say, one-stop shop. It means that each country will have an authority to access this compliance with this regulation. I have present the context is over everybody. It's a meaning to balance our safety and our privacy in the nowadays, because everybody knows that in Europe, in the worldwide, we have a threat very, very, very probably. It's the terrorism that we must have some kind of protection of safety and balance with the privacy. And this regulation will cover these issues, the safety of the citizens against terrorism, and the privacy of the citizens against the profile and the electronic surveillance of our personal data. There are actually a directive applying to all countries, in Portugal also, And this regulation will have some difference in the actual directive. The mainly difference is the broader territorial scope. It applies to players not established in the European Union, but whose activities consists of targeting data subjects in the European Union. Data subjects are the citizens. We are the data subjects. So this is a broader regulation that this is the first time that we apply in the Europe. The other change, mainly change, is in the data subjects rights that Sebastian covers in the last presentation with several techniques, several technology. The data breach notification, the organization will apply to report a personal data breach to the data protection authority. It's every country will have that data protection authority. That organization will apply to notificate every data personal data breach. It's all covers also the international data transfers, and the enforcement is also a big change because the data protection authorities will be entitled to impose fines arising between 2% and 4% of annual turnover. This will make some alerts in every organization. They don't want to pay these fines, so they will want to implement and to be compliant with this regulation. And we are here to help these organizations to apply this regulation. In all the regulation, if you read the articles, it covers the security management systems, what I call a personal data management system. So security is at the core of data protection. It covers not only the confidentiality, integrity, and availability, but also the data protection principles like lawfulness, fairness, and transparency, purpose, limitation, etc. This is a broader cover in the information management system. It's cover also a risk-based approach that I will explain in detail with the DPIA. And in the Article 35, for example, introduce the impact of potential personal data breach. Ou seja, it's a different approach in the traditional information security because we, in information security management, we focus in the impact of a information security breach for the information assets, of the loss of information assets. In this regulation, the impact is not the loss of the value of the information asset, but the damage for the citizen. The impact will cover the damage for citizens, not the damage for the organization. It's indirect because if the organization have to pay indemnization, have to covers also the impact of these fines. It covers also the notification of personal data. It's obligated to notify to the authority this personal data breach. It's obligated also to conduction of data protection impact assessment and a prior consultation with competent authorities. So, an information management system for personal data should cover the establishment of information management system for the protection of confidential integrity availability and their resilience, and the establishment of a process for testing, assessing, and evaluating the effectiveness of the adopted measures. This means that it's the same requirement in the ISO 27001 that required the effectiveness of the treatment plan of the measures. this is the same of the approach of the risk-based thinking in the ISO 27001, because we have to establish the organizational roles and responsibility of this information system, introduce and realize the assessment, risk assessment, and identify the controls that in the regulation they don't specify, they don't define control but measures, and they identify two kind of measures, technical measures that Sebastian have covered last presentation, and organizational measures that are transversal of the risk that is identified. This GDPR does not provide a direct reference to privacy enhanced technology that was presented by Sebastian. This addressed the pseudonymization and encryption that will have to be implemented as a technical measure to address the risks presented. So security of processing is not an isolated obligation of the regulation and a particular article. It should be considered with the overall regulation accountability framework. It's not a single article that explains this approach of information security and the risk base. It's embedded in all the articles of the GDPR. The article that covers is 35 and resumes as follows. A systematic description of the envisaged processing operation. This is the first step to implement the GDPR, is to analyze and make some assessment of the processing operations and the purpose of this processing, including, where applicable, the legitimate interest pursued by the controller. An assessment of the necessity of proportionality of processing operation in relation of the proposed. An assessment of the risks to the rights and freedoms of data subjects referred to in paragraph 1. And measures envisaged to address the risks, including safeguards, security measures, and the mechanism to ensure the protection of personal data and to demonstrate compliance with this regulation, taking into account the rights, legitimate interests of data subjects and other persons concerned. This is the main article that covers this risk-based approach. The goal of this data protection impact assessment is to identify what are the processing operations are likely to result in high risk. The regulation defines that we must have this impact assessment only in the only in the processing operation that have high risk. So this is a question: what is a processing that produces a high risk? And the outcome should be taken into account when determining the appropriate measures. So it is the same approach of the risk management. So the question is, what are the processing operations that are likely to result in high risk? If here, also the impact of non-conformity with this regulation. If the organization don't realize the impact assessment, could be penalized and could be pay the fines will cover 10 million or 2% of turnover. European Union define what will cover, what are the articles that define the needed of a data protection impact assessment. As I say, is the question is if it is likely to result in high risk. It depends on our organization, and they have to define what is high risk process operation high risks. And there are several conditions that obligate implies the realize of the impact assessment, like with the authorities or exceptions covered in Article 35. So, what what are we should cover the this impact assessment in a only one process operation or a several? My opinion and the regulator defines that we if there are different processes, for example, for customer or for employees in data personal data processor, we should have different data. Data impact assessments. Even in Article 35, specified that a single assessment may address a set of similar processing operations. This is difficult because what is the similar processing operations? We have several controllers. We can assume that is a similar, but we will have to assure that the data that we collect from this impact assessment is actually to assume that this impact assessment for this process operation can be similar to another process operations. So. For example, when the process operation involves joint controllers, they need to define their respective obligation precisely, even if these process operations cover only one process with different roles. We have to define the responsibility and to collect the data from the different stakeholders. What are the subjects to a DPI? 35 defined this, what is likely to result in high risks. For example, systematic and extensive evaluation of personal aspects relating to natural person, which is based on automated processing, including profiling, and on which decisions are based that produce legal effects concerning natural person of similarly significant effect natural person. Processing on a large scale of special categories of data referred in Article 9, or of personal data relating to criminal convictions and offences referred to into Article 10. A systematic monitoring of a public accessible area on a large scale. These are the examples that are presented in the regulation for the processing that result in high risks. The European Union defined also criteria for considering what is high risk processing operations. If it is evaluating or scoring the personal data, for example, aspects concerning the data subject's performance at work, economic situation, health, personal preference, interests, reliability or behavior, location or movement, everything in the evaluation or scoring is considered high risk to the citizens. Automated decision making with legal or similar significant effect. Systematic monitoring is also, and the sensitive data. For example, the criminal conviction or offense that will have high risk. There are several other criteria. For example, data processing on large scale, data sets that have been matched or combined, or data concerning vulnerable data subjects. All of these criteria, we shall analyze if our processing operations cover these criteria, and we recommend that analyze if the process operations cover these criteria and define a criteria to consider if it is high risk or not high risk. For example, I have here in the For example, in a hospital, processing its patients' genetic and health data, have sensitive data, have data concerning vulnerable data subjects, should be have a DPA required. Another example that I have is when it doesn't need a DPA. It's only, for example, an e-commerce website displaying the adverts for vintage car parts involving limited profiling based on past purchase behavior on certain parts of its website. It's not covered two or more criteria, but in this example, we have to analyze the process and identify if only these criteria are presented in the data processing or not. So, when isn't a DPA required? It's defined in Article 35. It's likely to result in high risk and freedoms. Is not likely to result. When the nature, scope, and context of purpose of processing are very similar to the processing for which DPA have been carried out. In such case, results of DPA for similar processing can be used. Is the same criteria that I have explained earlier, that I have to do a DPA if I have this data and information from similar process. But we should take care of this similar process because maybe they are not the information is not actually is not integrated, and we should carry a DPA or where the processing is included on the optional list established by the supervisory authority. So these authorities, these national authorities, will publish a list of processing operations that are obliged or not to this DPA. This list is not existing yet, but is will be produced for European Union. The components of a DPA it's established also in the regulation, and said that we have to make three steps to do risk management. This establishing the context is the first step in the every risk assessment methodology, like 31,000 or 27,005, is the first step, is establishing the context. Taking into account the nature, scope, context, and purpose of the processing and source of the risk. So we have to establish the context of the process, the data processing process, and identify what are the threats and the vulnerabilities, and calculate the risk. Also, assessing the risks and treating the risk is the same. It's the same of every risk management methodology. So in the Article 35 states this description of the invasion envisaged processing operation, an assessment of necessity of proportional of processing, an assessment of the risk to the rights and the freedoms, and the measures addressed to risk and demonstrate compliance with this regulation. So what this means that the DPA AI, the report will be useful to demonstrate compliance with this regulation. So next I will present the data protection impact assessment, very simple, that we can apply in the small or medium companies. Start with the definition of the process. Understanding and evaluation of the impacts, definition of the possible threats and evaluation of their likelihood, evaluating the of risk, comparing to the risk criteria, and select the appropriate measures and implement and maintain the measures. So this is a process, not not end process, it's a continuum process that should be executed when every change occurs in the context, not to realize the assessment once and review the assessment every year, but if any issue and any part of the context is changed, we shall review the results of the assessment and or made a new assessment. So in the definition of the processing operation in this context, the purpose is to understand what is the personal data processing operation. If it is, what are the types of personal data? What is the purpose? What are the means used for the processing of personal data? Where does the processing of personal data take place? And the categories of data subjects and the recipients of data. So if you answer this question, we have a knowledge of the context of the processing operation. The next step is the understanding and evaluating the impact. And we should consider the type of personal data, the criticality of processing operation, the volume of personal data processed, and the special characteristics, identifiable data subject, possible secondary effects. So we have to evaluate, understanding and evaluate the impact. And for this, the impact is assessed separately for lost confidentiality, integrity, and available. It's the same in the 27001. When we are evaluating the impact, we must evaluate impact in these three data information characteristics: confidentiality, integrity, and availability. And consider all possible cases of unauthorized disclosure, alteration, or destruction, and evaluate impact based on the worst case scenario. So in this phase of the impact assessment, we identify what are the risk scenarios of the data processing. I propose also a level of impact in the four levels, very high and low. The impact of personal data breach. And very very high it's when individuals may encounter significant or even irreversible consequences which they may not overcome to work, long-term psychological or physical ailments or death. This is and low the low level where individuals may encounter a few minor inconvenience which they will overcome without any problem, time spent re-entering information, annoyance, irritation. So, in the every threat that we must identify, every risk scenarios, we in the three characteristics, confidentiality, integrity, available, we have to classify this level of impact. These are examples of possible threats. An attacker injects codes into the form of a website that we saw yesterday. An attacker performs a man-in-middle attack that saw yesterday also. An employee steals personal data files from the internal system. An hospital employee changes a critical parameter. It's very dangerous that if we change a parameter in a medical, we can cause deaths due to a power cut. It causes not availability, or a USB flash drive with personal data files is lost in transit by a contractor. It's these are examples of threats. We have to identify these possible threats. Focus in the process of processing personal data. So we have to consider these dimensions of the threats in the depends of on the process. If they have the process is working in network and technical reserves or not. And we have to answer these questions to identify if if they are a threat or not. For example, is any part of the processing of personal data performed through the internet or not? So what we do is to answer all of these questions, identify what are the level of impact of these threats. The other is the process procedures to the processing of personal data. If the procedure have the roles defined, they are documented, are the employees allowed to bring and use their own device or not? So there are several issues that we must consider when we are identified the threats of the processing of personal data. The other dimension is the parties, persons involved in the processing. Is the processing of personal data performed by an undefined number of employees? If they have NDAs or not signed, do the persons parties involved in data processing operations neglect to security stores? If there is an awareness program? If this kind of questions make us understanding of the threats that are in this process. The other is the business sector. It's different because if I am made a data protection impact assessment in a hospital or in a railway company, the business sector is different and they are they have different threats. So we should collect information of the cyber attacks. And what are the volume of these individuals? Are there any security best practices if this is implementing any security controls or not? Because if you know that if we have already security controls implemented, the maturity of our process and the threat is lower. So this is an example also the likelihood or the probability of the threat. It's very simple. It's three levels that we cover in the likelihood. It is high, medium, and low. And with the likelihood and the impact is for the citizen. Of the personal data breach, we can present a risk matrix, and very similar to 27005 in NXD. The difference is we consider high risk in the impact level low, impact level very high, and the probability low. For example, in the annex the D of the 27005 standard, this is not considered a high risk. This here we consider in this person in privacy this is a high risk because even if the probability is low, if it occurs. The impact level design can produce deaths or can produce several damage to the citizen that are not recovery, and the organization have to pay indemnizations and fines to the authority. So the next step in the data protection impact assessment is to select the measures. Following this evaluation, the organization can proceed with selection of appropriate security measures for protection for personal data. In the regulation, they define these two kinds of the controls or measures, organization and technical. What I will present is these measures aligned or matched with the 27,001 Annex A. Even so, depending on the context of personal data, we should also design several controls, security controls, depending on the industry or depending on the regulation or specific legislations. In last presentation, Sebastian have referred to, for example, this e-privacy directive or NIS directive the European companies are required to accomplish this also this regulation. So these measures I will present here these the measures aligned with the security controls of 27,001, but this depends on the context in the sector, in the business and the organization can design and implement others controls. So these are the security measures here that it's referring in the regulation, and I made the correspondence with the security controls. Okay. Yeah. So the next step is to prepare a treatment plan, identify these measures, and define what are the responsible, the accountable to implement these measures, deadlines, and what is the effectiveness criteria that will be used to assess the effectiveness of treatment plan. So in this phase, what we suggest is to monitor, measure, analyze, and evaluate security methods with the effectiveness of each measures, and conduct also internal audits and penetration tests to verify if these measures are effective or not. If they are effective or not, if they reduce the risk. And to reduce the risk, we have to reduce the impact. So in this approach, the only option that we present is the mitigation of the risk, not the transfer or the not to do this process. So we have to identify and analyze if this is effective or not. So we do it with internal audits and the penetration tests. Conduct also management reviews because this will imply to implement a management system, a personal data information management system. What I recommend is to implement a 27,001 with these additional criteria or additional requirements of the regulation. And establish and plan improvements based on management reviews, the improvement cycle that we have to implement also in the compliance with the regulation. So there are others frameworks. One of them is 29,134. This is under development, this standard. And the other standards are the national frameworks that are developing. For example, these are from Spain, these are from UK, and these are from France, and I think these are from Germany. Standard Data Protection Model. These frameworks are used regional, and what I recommend is to use an international standard and a simplified assessment according to the context and the business sector. So my conclusions are the regulation is go beyond mere adoption of specific measures. It's not intent to only to put the technology and mitigate the risk. It's more broad. It's to implement information security management system for protection of confidentiality, integrity of available, and the resilience of personal data. So it's it covers more than the 27,001. To comply with the regulation and avoid the fines, the organization should do a data protection impact assessment, evaluate the risk and implement the security measures and to mitigate the risks, and monitor, measuring, analyze, and evaluate the effectiveness of security measures implemented or the management system. So this approach is similar to implementation of the 27,001 with the specification of personal data and the difference that in the risk we evaluate impact for the citizen, not the impact for the organization. The organizations that are already certified 27,001 have facilitated to work because they have only to make this impact assessment and review this management system according to this regulation. So this is my conclusions that now if you have any questions, I'm glad to answer them. Thank you for your presence in the last conference.
Sorry, I have a question. Was this designed to be aligned with 27,001?
Yes, it's my recommendation. The regulation don't specify the 27,001. Specified some parameters that are included in 7,001, but don't require. Specify also another thing that I don't refer here. Specify that the conformity assessment will be made by certification bodies also. So this is this certification scheme is not yet defined. It should be defined next year. And probably PECB will be one of the certification bodies that will assess the implementation of the GDPR.
And when you were talking about fines in the context of the 2-6%, what is the definition of turnover? Is that, how do you measure that? What is that the descriptive of?
It's the VAB, the
cross revenue?
Yeah, the cross revenue.
It's the revenue, okay. It's the revenue of global. So not just within Europe. So it's global.
Yes, yeah, global. It's global.
It's the numbers.
Yeah, because for example in Portugal this it's been sold for a huge business for lawyers. They are preparing, the lawyers are preparing for doing business with these fines.
Okay.